This is the EWN Radio Network. Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur with your host, Steve Kidd, third-generation minister and business coach. Join Steve and his guests to get answers to your questions and help break through to the next level in your business.
This is Steve. Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur. Thank you for being there today. Thank you for turning us on, for listening to Thriving Entrepreneur today. I am so glad that you took the time out of your day to listen to what we have here for you. It means a lot to me. It's really important to me and to Kathy as well that we know that we're putting out into the world things that are of value. But we also really want to be sure that we let you know just how much we appreciate you and how grateful we are that you take the time to listen to the show. We want to talk to you today about something that is really going to impact you, is really going to help you. Let me ask you a question. What would making a little bit more money do in your life? What would making quite a bit more money do in your life? What would making a whole lot of money do in your life? It's interesting because often when it comes to discussions about money, we immediately put up a block. We throw up a phrase that's something like, well, you know, I'm not as interested in the money as I am making sure that I really reach people. And I hope, I really do hope that everything that you do has an amazing impact on the world around you, as well as specifically with the people that you are meant to reach. You know, I'm always telling you, you're here for a reason. You have a purpose. You have a message and a place in the world that only you can fill. So that right in and of itself, just you being the best you, is amazingly, it's a game changer. It's a world changer just in and that. But here's the thing that sometimes we push off to the side when we're trying to make an impact. And that is the simple fact of us having the amount of money to be able to do all of the things we want to do, not just some of them, not make choices. You know, I'd like to do these 10 things, but I can only afford to do these two, but really be able to do all 10 of them. I want to give you a visual image that came to me the other day, and I've used it throughout a whole lot of years, but it came to me really vividly the other day. I want you to close your eyes for a second, and I want you to really imagine one of those big drains that go underneath of the highway, you know, the big circle round pipes, or, you know, they're even maybe just big circles of cement. Think about all the TVs and movies that you've seen that are the flood, areas there in LA, you know, where most of the time they're driving cars down through them and stuff, and there's no water there or a trickle of there, but you know, they're intended for, flash flooding, that it could be that totally full. I want you to think about a pipe that kind of size, really huge, bigger than that, if your mind can do that. Okay. Now you've got that clearly in mind. Now, what I want you to think about is absolute 100% constant flow of water going through that. That means that there's water coming in, there's water going out, and there's always water in the middle, filled all the way to the top and the bottom and all of that, completely flowing, completely full. I want you to really have that in mind. Do you have that in your mind? With your eyes closed, can you see water just rushing through that? That is what we want money to be in our lives. We want it to come in as fast as it can, flow through our lives, and go out so that we can do all of the things that we want to do in life. And in order to do that, we need to be the best version of ourselves that we can be. We need to reach for the things that are going to make the greatest, the biggest, the most world-changing impact that we possibly can make. So how do we do that? Well, I'm glad you asked. We're going to actually spend this whole entire episode talking to you about how you can be the best version of yourself and take that to be able to really truly change the world and also have the money to make that impact, make those choices, and make that change that you were put here on the planet to do. You excited? You ready to jump into it? I'd like to introduce to you, I'm so excited to have my guest here today. Her name is Wendyy Bailey. Hi, Wendyy. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Steve. I appreciate the opportunity.
Oh, well, I'm just so glad to have you here with us. I got a really fun opportunity to have a conversation with you a couple of days ago, just really briefly. But I'd really like an opportunity for myself as well as the listeners to really get to know who you are. So tell us, who is Wendyy Bailey?
Well, let's see. I am a master business coach and income acceleration mentor. I've been in the industry for almost 14 years, and if you can imagine, that means I've seen a lot of ups and downs. I've seen a lot of people come and go, and I feel like I really and truly believe that I know now what it takes to be sustainable in this industry, in the coaching profession. On a personal note, I'm the single mom of a thriving 26-year-old son, and he is the apple of my eye and the joy in my heart. And I love hanging with him and spending time with him when he decides it's okay to spend time with mom, if you can imagine what I mean. That's a lot about me. What else can I tell you, Steve?
So with your business, you know, obviously, after 14 years, I mean, definitely the concept of being a master coach, I think that definitely applies. You know, what kind of people do you like to work with?
I like to work primarily with coaches, speakers, trainers, consultants, and emerging thought leaders. And let me say a little bit more about what I mean by that. As you can tell, I work with people who are in the professional training and coaching industry specifically. And when I say emerging thought leaders, sometimes people are really vibrant in social media or in their marketing efforts, but they don't quite know how to walk a potential client down the path of working with them. So I throw emerging thought leaders in there because that's who they are. They just may not know how to turn their thought leadership into profits, and that's where I come in. A lot of what I do with coaches, speakers, trainers, and consultants is profit work, income acceleration, revenue generation. It's looking at their bottom line and tweaking their sales and marketing or building in whatever they need that may be missing from their sales and marketing strategies so that they can actually accelerate their income. They can make more money. They can increase cash flows. They can bring in more clients. And who doesn't want that?
Absolutely. We all want more cash flow, more profitability, more clients. You know, so talk to the people about the concept of why, you know, I mean, some people are just like, well, you know, but it doesn't need to be all about money. Why is it that often when we start into conversations like this, we do talk about profitability and money and those kind of things?
Well, it's because people who are resistant, let me say it this way, people who are resistant to it being about money really don't understand that money equals freedom. Money equals freedom. And when I say that, I mean free for you to travel, free for you to make choices about how much time you spend in your business, freedom for you to do things that you want to do when you want to do them, and you're not tethered to what happens in your business. So money really gives you those opportunities. So when I hear a coach say, oh, it's really not about the money, I just want to give and I just want to serve, I go, yeah, but let me make sure I understand this. Do you want to spend more time with your family? Do you want to spend time like on a date night, more regular date nights with your husband? Do you want to travel with your family? Do you want to go places? If you're a single person, do you want to go places and do things and be able to give to people in a much bigger way? I've seen people who I've worked with come through, and because of income acceleration, now they're able to be more charitable in their giving. And what I mean by that is they can really financially support nonprofit organizations that really resonate with them in terms of how they want to give and who they want to give to. So money is really about freedom. So when we talk about income acceleration and revenue generation and client infusion and building big profits, I'm talking about giving you the freedom to choose what you want to do. And that's important.
Oh, it absolutely is. I remember hearing Tony Robbins say one time that, money doesn't solve any of your problems. It doesn't keep you from having struggles in life, but it does let you show up to them in better style and able to be able to take care of them. And that second part is what he really emphasizes, is it's the ability, the freedom, I love that word that you used, to really be able to take care of a problem when it comes up, you know, whether it be personal stuff, you know, sicknesses happen, things happen, kids have opportunities to go to a foreign country as an exchange student or whatever. You need to have the money to be able to make those opportunities available or to solve the problems as they come up. And that simply really is all that it's about.
That is so right. That is so right, Steve. I tell you, for some reason, we as coaches, when we enter the marketplace, think that what we do is really about sacrifice. It's really about, what's the other word I'm looking for? I'll just stay with sacrifice for just a second. It's really about sacrifice, and in some ways it is, but sacrifice and struggle are not synonymous. They're not synonymous. When you are in a position to, as you mentioned, Tony Robbins, give in style and do what you do to care for others in style, it has more meaning not just for them but for you, because nobody wants you to give out of struggle. No one wants you to serve out of struggle. People are okay knowing that you might sacrifice, but sacrifice is not, again, synonymous with struggle. You've got to give and sacrifice, but you've also got to be free to choose how that sacrifice looks and how it feels and how it shows up in your world. And as a coach, you can coach all the people on the planet who really need you, but if you're struggling, you're not really serving them well, because that hinders your ability to serve.
How are you struggling? How are you serving? How are you showing up in the world? What are the things that you want to put forward? And what are the things that are getting in the way of that because of the very real, very normal life things that come into each and every one of our lives? It's really something that we all wish didn't happen, but we all know does. And so rather than pretending that it's just going to go away, let's just be really upfront about it and really face it. So let's take one thing that you're struggling with right now. Let's identify it, make it really clear. And then as we move on here after the commercial break, we can get into some specific things that you can do to be able to eliminate or at least begin to reduce that struggle in your life. Does that sound like a good plan? All right. So like I said, we're going to take a quick commercial break, and then we'll be right back here on Thriving Entrepreneur.
Never has there been a better time for women to hack success. The shift is on and the breakthroughs are real. We're taking success to a whole nother level. Join us at the Women's Success Summit, a gathering of dynamic, smart women helping women. We want to learn about you and what you have to offer. Bring your A game and be prepared to transact some business. Oh, and by all means, dress to impress.
Register at eWomenNetwork.com.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to wehelpyouthrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur. I'm here with Wendyy Bailey, and she is talking to us today, and we're discussing the whole concept of your breakthrough. And before we get into solution space, we've been really diving into that ability that you have to serve and what things get in the way of that. We want to always serve from our overflow, not be serving from our need, from our desperation. It's really, really difficult to sell when you're desperate. And it's just really difficult to be genuine and unique when every time you look at somebody, you're thinking about the things that are going on in your life and the needs that you have so immediately right now in your present.
A lot of people who have never been in that place where they're really serving don't really understand how difficult it is to be on a stage or even one-on-one, but especially from a stage, and really be dynamic and powerful and give people what they need for that day when what's going through the back of your head is, I'm going through foreclosure. I hope that they don't find my car so that they repossess it. My child is sick, but I can't afford the doctor bills. You know, those are the kind of real life kind of things that we can't just go, well, no big deal. Let's just go serve with excellence. You know, they're with you everywhere you go. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that's when struggle is more predominant in your world than sacrifice. When you've got those kinds of things going on, that's not sacrifice. It truly is struggle.
Well, and I know a couple of things. I had an interesting statistic come across a show actually a couple of months ago that almost 80% of millennials list what they do as having a greater purpose in the world being more important than the money. So I want to acknowledge that up front to everybody listening. And I also know that for female entrepreneurs, which is the predominant listening audience we have, that they want what they do to have more of a purpose than just, dollars in the bank account. And I get that. We need to understand that in all of those things, we need to put us on that list of the people that we want to help and serve.
Mm-hmm. First, at the very top of the list. At the very top of the list. I know we as coaches have heard this a lot, and it's an overused metaphor, but I'm going to use it one more time, and that is the flight safety instructions. When you're traveling on an airplane and they tell you if you're traveling with someone who is unable to care for themselves, you put the mask on yourself first so that you're able to care for them. It's overused, but it is a powerful metaphor for how we live and how we serve, especially in our businesses. We've got to take care of ourselves first. And let me tell you, Steve, for me that's especially important, and it's at the heart of why I do the work that I do. I have been sick off and on for a number of years, And in 2015, there were some things that happened in 2014 that led me to be off the grid, unplugged from my business for all of 2015, the whole year. So if you can imagine, it's like, wow, we didn't see you in social media. No, you didn't. We didn't see you talking to your list. No, you didn't. You didn't see me blogging. You didn't see me vlogging. You didn't see me in 2015 doing any work in my business, and it was due to illness. Now, what I will tell you is, while I am an income acceleration mentor, master business coach, and I focus on income acceleration and revenue generation and client infusion and all of those good things, what drives my work is mindset. And the reason for that is because all of the years that I've been in business, years ago I was diagnosed with major depressive disorder, clinical depression, and I've seen ebbs and flows personally because of that. And in 2011, I changed doctors, and the doctor changed my meds, and it sent me up and down on a roller coaster for 4 years. I was in business for 4-5 years. At the end of 2014, and I'm being, you know, really transparent here because I want you to understand why the work I do is so important to me. At the end of 2014, I had surgery that literally, because of the major depressive disorder already being there as part of my system and who I am, the surgery drove me off of a cliff emotionally, physically, mentally. So when I say I was off the grid in 2015, I was literally in bed the whole time, not really able to do very much for myself or for my business. So the work that I do that is so very important to me is mindset work. Because when I came back to the marketplace, Steve, what I didn't know for sure was if I had a voice in the marketplace or if anyone would even recognize the voice that I did have. What became really clear for me was mindset was everything. So I started to feast on affirmations. I started to feast on what I call intention statements. What I started to feast on were books and videos and people, digital mentors, and things that really supported me in bringing my mindset back to the marketplace so that I could serve in a big way with people. Now, there's a part of the story that I've left out that I want to make sure I mention. In October of 2015, I changed doctors, and the doctor that I changed to put me on a whole new treatment plan, which changed my life. Changed my life. Mm-hmm. So with all of that going on, when I say mindset is everything, I'm telling you it totally is. I closed the business that I had for, at that point, a little more than 13 years at the end of 2015, and symbolically, it was a symbolic that I did it, and I opened a whole new business focused on the work that I do now. A lot of what I do is mindset work, because in order for you to accelerate your income, in order for you to really be consistent in your cash flows, you've got to have the right mindset to be there. Since January, I've launched that business. I've filled two programs. Mindset is everything. I have grown a movement on Facebook and a private Facebook group to more than 400 members in about 6 weeks' time, which is phenomenal for what I've done. I've presented and hosted a 5-day telesummit with a total of 20 speakers that was tremendously successful. Now, I'm sharing all of this not to boast and brag, but to let you know mindset is everything, Steve. Mindset is everything. I've flooded my whole world with mindset. And what I know is when you have the highest possible mindset about what you can do in your business, then it shows up like consistent action. Consistent action, those are two of my favorite words in 2016. Consistent action, it means you keep going, you keep moving, you keep doing things daily, monthly, yearly that move your business forward. It's also about effective sales and marketing. It means that you have a strategy for your selling and a strategy for your marketing that is about boosting your bottom line, and you're effectively rolling it out through your consistent action. And then the third thing are four words that I just, again, these are four of my favorite words for the year. Expectant faith in action, F-A-I-T-H, in action. Expectant faith in action says you move, and you know when you move to expect something favorable to happen to you in your business, in that day, in that moment, in that week, in that month, because you are moving with purpose. It's sort of a pray and then move your feet. Expectant faith in action. So three things I mentioned: consistent action, that means daily, weekly, monthly activities designed to move your business forward. It means effective sales and marketing, which means you've got a strategy in both of those areas that are partners in crime, so to speak. They really pair really well with consistent action to make sure that you are doing something. You have a strategy that helps you add people, dollars, money in the black results to your bottom line. And then the expectant faith in action, which is about moving your feet. Moving your feet. I know I said a lot.
No. That's really good stuff. Because, I mean, in a nutshell, that is the three things that you need to do to get started. And by started, I use that term kind of generically, because you could have been in business, like Wendyy was talking about, you know, for 13, 14 years and be at a place where you need to start something new. Could be a new program you're starting today, could be a new outlook on life, any of those things. You know, I think that really is a very concise way of putting the very three things that you need to do to get started with a new anything, a new weight loss program, a new, you know, a new job. You know, it doesn't even have to be in your business. A new way of parenting your kids. You know, because don't let anybody fool you. You know, there is that whole element of sales and marketing to your kids when you take a different approach.
Yeah.
You know, got to sell them on that one, too. So it really is good.
It's fun because the same things that make us really effective in business are the things that actually are what's going to make us effective in life too, or vice versa. The things that make us really quality individuals are the same skills that last over the long haul of being a business person. You can come in with a lot of tricks and things like that to scam the system for a while, but in the end, those things always catch up with you. But the thing that always remains true is when you are approaching from a place of integrity. And the three steps that Wendyy Wise been really revealing to us and talking us through here are just like the foundational, the cornerstone, if you will, building blocks to really, really approaching a situation and having the outcome that you're looking for. So with that in mind, I want to take another quick break here, and then we're going to be right back to talk in about some more about the three steps and dive into it even a little bit deeper. We'll be right back here on Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is the EWN Radio Network.
Never has there been a better time for women to hack success. The shift is on and the breakthroughs are real. We're taking success to a whole nother level. Join us at the Women's Success Summit, a gathering of dynamic, smart women helping women. We want to learn about you and what you have to offer. Bring your A game and be prepared to transact some business. Oh, and by all means, dress to impress.
Register at eWomenNetwork.com.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. now is your time because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to wehelpyouthrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur. I'm here with my special guest, Wendyy Y. Bailey, and we are talking about three simple things that you can do to really, really start something, whether it be something in your life or something in your business. These are three such great, impactful, foundational things that I really, really hope you're taking notes on it. And that it really does make an impact in how you approach all of the new things as you start them in your life.
So say the three things again for us, Wendyy, because I really want to cement that into people.
Sure. The first is consistent action, and I like to repeat things. So consistent action, consistent action, consistent action. That's whatever you do that moves your business forward daily, weekly, and monthly. Consistent action. It means that you don't slow down. You get into a groove around what you're doing to build your business, and you stay in that groove and keep moving. Let me say something about that one, one more thing about that one. I saw a picture quote, and I love Instagram for all of the wisdom that comes from people through their picture quotes. And it sort of went like this: every day is a new day for you to start moving forward, for you to do something that moves you forward. So if you have a bad day, the next day start again. If that day is challenging, the next day you get another opportunity to start again. Keep moving. That's what consistent action is really about. The second thing is an effective sales and marketing strategy. Now, those are partners. What is it? Sales, marketing gets you known, sales gets you paid, is what I hear a lot of people say. But they're partners, they're married, so you've got to have a really solid selling strategy as well as a really great marketing strategy for how you're going to get known and how you're ultimately going to get paid through the sales. And then the third thing is expectant faith in action. Expectant faith in action. It's because you've got to believe at the highest level what's possible as a result of your next move. You've got to believe at the highest level of what's possible when it comes to growing your business, when it comes to losing weight, when it comes to parenting your children. You've got to believe that it's possible, because otherwise your actions will reflect your lack of belief. You've got to believe it's possible. You've got to know, wow. And let me kind of turn this back to my own example that, you know, I was very transparent about. I had to believe that not only did I have a voice, still have a voice in the marketplace, but I had to believe that my voice was powerful. And in believing that, and I got to tell you, Steve, I believed it with all of my heart and soul, which is what led me to take consistent action every day, every minute sometimes in my business, in my life, to get back to where I knew I belonged. So pray and then move your feet. Let your actions reflect your highest belief in what's possible in your situation, again, whether it's losing weight or parenting your children or building your business or going and getting clients or, you know, going and getting a great job, whatever that looks like for you. Maybe it's some, you know, six-figure, seven-figure contract, training contract or consulting contract. Whatever that is, you've got to believe in the possibility of it, because that will, your actions will really identify what your beliefs truly are. Your beliefs are really founded in how you see yourself in the world, how you show up in the world, And it's not about anybody but you. It's about how you show up. And you and I know this expression. It's a come from. What's the place you come from when you perform your daily, weekly, and monthly actions? That's what the last one is about, that expectant faith in action, is about what do you believe is true. What do you believe is true? And the belief in what's true starts with what you believe is true about yourself. And that's where you have the greatest power. Can I share one quick diagram with everybody? Okay. On your paper, I want you to draw a circle and make it big enough for you to draw, put something inside of it. So a circle on your paper. And think of this circle as the boundary for what you can manage, what you have the most control over, and what you truly have responsibility for. So when you think of the circle and inside the circle being those things that you have great responsibility in and super management of and total responsibility for, what do you think belongs inside the circle? I always ask this question and people tell me things, but I'm going to keep going. Inside the circle are things like your thoughts, your feelings, your beliefs, your behaviors, your actions, your reactions, which I kind of see those as knee-jerk opportunities. Your responses are more well thought out than a reaction is. Your feelings, your choices, everything about you. Like, we could go on and on with more and more, but you get the idea. It's everything about you. Conversely, outside the circle are the things for which you have no responsibility, management of, or control over. And those would be other people's thoughts, other people's feelings, other people's emotions, other people's actions and reactions and responses, and other people's choices. So whether it is outside the circle or inside the circle, if you use this diagram as a gauge, then you'll know whether you're responding to something about your weight loss. You'll know whether it is something about your parenting that is yours to manage and control. You can't control other people. You can't control that teenager that may be giving you what for in their teenage years. What you can do is manage your responses to them. I told you my son is 26 now. We had our moments when he was 17. And, you know, what I had to learn and remind myself of was what I teach and coach on every day is this diagram. I had to recognize that my power was in how I responded and how I chose and what I said and what I did. It wasn't about what he said or did. It was always about me. And today we enjoy a really close relationship and really kind of went through a short period in his teens where it was challenging because I had to learn to listen and not talk. I had to learn to hear what he was saying and support him in the hearing with my own wisdom. But I couldn't make him follow what I said. I couldn't make him do what I wanted him to do. So, you know, again, I practice what I preach here, and I know that the most power you have is on the inside the circle stuff. That's why the affirmations are so important in how you think. That's why the intention statements are so powerful in how you behave. That's why beliefs become something that you can manage and have great power in how you manage them and how it shows up in your relationships with others. Mindset is everything, and it's got to start with you.
And the core of that comes from a great saying that an old friend of mine used to always use all the time, and that's control what you can and don't worry about what you can't control. I'm going to say that again. Control what you can and don't worry about what you can't control. And that's what snags most of us up is we're so busy trying to control the other people in our lives, their emotions, their actions, their reactions, their choices, you know, all of their stuff. It's so funny that you mentioned when your son was 17. I was actually in a session with a good friend of us. In fact, Jessica's been on the show. You know, it was Kathy and I and Maya, our daughter, the only one that's left at home. We have others that are grown now, but the only one that's left at home. And we were talking about the concept of your side of the net. I'm sure you've probably heard that one before. You know, and we were helping Maya understand the concept of, you know, you live in a world where everybody else is on the other side of the net and you want to play a game with them. You want to have interactions and conversations and relationships with them, but their stuff is on their side of the net and your stuff is on your side of the net. You can't jump the net and go take care of their stuff. No matter how much you may notice that they're not doing it right, that they don't, you know, that they don't understand or they're not getting your feelings or any of those kind of things, you can't jump over on that side of the net. You need to take care of your side of the net. And it was a fun conversation, a really tough one, you know, for an early teenager, you know, back when it was. And you know, I think she's slowly getting it. You know, those are some advanced concepts, but
they are. They are. I think my son at 26 is just in the past couple of years starting to understand more of what I told him. I hear him, he shares stories of conversations he has with his friends today, and I just kind of look at him and go, wow, you were listening. Wow, you heard what I said. Wow, I'm so thankful, you know, that has to be part of it, because at 17 he didn't really get it. At least I didn't think he did. And now that he's 26, he's sharing some of the same things that I shared with him years before, which is really a good feeling as a parent.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I'll say to all of you parents out there, it will come back around. It's so much fun to watch my 28-year-old. You know, she's a mom of two. You know, she lives a really typical mom life. She posted on Facebook, you know, one of the things that you have to come to terms with is the fact that at some point you have to grow up and, you know, realize that your parents were just people too. And, you know, then she posted an article that went with it about, you know, the 10 things to realize about, you know, about your parents, you know, for you to become an adult. And I just kind of sat back and I was like, yeah, you know, because I watch her, you know, she's going through it with her, you know, with her two little ones. You know, she's got one that's just started school and one that's a toddler, you know, and they keep her jumping, you know. And, you know,
it
kind of
come back
around
to them, I tell you.
Yeah, you know. It's like the age-old saying of, you know, casting your bread upon the water. You know, if you throw out the bread on the water enough times, you know, then soon bread is washing in with every wave that hits the shore. Mm-hmm. But it takes a while, you know, and it takes a lot of bread. And sometimes the things that you think you're saying, they may not feel like they're getting through, but they're, you know, they're getting instilled in there. And that's good for us to know. It's good for us to know as business people too, because often we get to a place in business where we feel like we're really putting it out there, and people just aren't getting it. You know, we're not getting the feedback we want. And we need to have that same mindset of, you know, when I'm putting good stuff out into the world, it will reap a reward.
Yeah. Yeah, without a doubt. And what most people don't recognize is that the fruits that you lay today, you know, what you put out there today, you won't see the rewards typically for those fruits for another 6 or 9 months. So that's really an acknowledgement for perseverance. Sometimes when you put things out, it happens immediately. But sometimes it takes 6 to 9 months, especially in a sales and marketing cycle, for people to really see what you're doing. Let me give you a quick case in point. I have some social media updates that are automated through social oomph is the tool that I use. There are a bunch of them out there. There's Edgar, there's Hootsuite. There are a whole bunch of different tools out there for folks. But I've automated some of my social media updates in social oomph, OOMPH.com, socialoomph.com. And what I'm seeing is I set up some automated social media updates back in late January, and what I'm seeing now is people are starting to notice them, and they are liking them, and they're commenting on them. So the number of likes have grown since they first started rolling out. Yeah, it's the same update that I run consistently over a period of time so that people see them. And different people are seeing them in different places. So they see them on Twitter. They see them on LinkedIn. Those are the two I use primarily on social oomph. And what's really cool about them seeing them now is they're starting to say, hey, let me kind of reach out and find out more about what you do. So I've gotten, you know, some requests for virtual interviews and radio show guests, you know, appearances. So what I'm saying to you is it takes a while. It's now April, so we're talking about 4 months, not quite four months that those social media updates have been running. It takes a while sometimes. It really, really does.
Oh, yeah. Well, and in fact, with our platinum clients that we, you know, that we work with, Kathy and I actually always make them commit up front to a minimum of 6 months of working with us when we're going to start, you know, teaching them about marketing campaigns and things like that. And the reason being is that, you know, there are things you can do in social media. Like you were saying, you know, you started a whole brand new group. Well, to go from zero to 100, you know, that's majorly, it feels great. You know, it's huge stuff, but it isn't going to stick. Even if it happens in that first month, and in fact, even isn't going to stick if it happens in that first 90 days, you really need a minimum of 6 months to really solidify that marketing program to the point where, A, you're doing it consistently, and B, the people that you're trying to reach are consistently used to seeing that. You know, because people need to hear from us. You know, it used to be, it's so funny because I've been in sales, you know, for forever. I mean, I'm 49 right. years old and I started at five. So, you know,
sure,
44
sure.
years, you know, and, you know, back in the day we used to say, you know, when I was a teen, you know, selling door to door, you know, the teachers always said you need to talk to a person 3 to 5 times before you can get a yes. You have to ask for the sale 3 to 5 times in an in-person door-to-door conversation before you can get the yes. Well, these days, you know, we live mostly in a social media world. That number's gone up to somewhere, depending on whose statistic you
12.
Want to believe, somewhere around 12 that you have to ask them for the sale before they, you know, even are taking seriously that you actually were asking them for the sale, you know? And so it takes that consistency. So that's really good that you said that. You got to keep doing it and be consistent about it. Speaking of which, Wendyy, I really would like for you to share with the audience what they can do to interact with you, to get some help from you, those kind of things.
Well, there are a couple of ways. I like to start people off in my private Facebook group. So I want you to go to beyondlimitslive.com. That's beyondlimitslive.com. And we're a really busy group. Like I said, it's about 400, right at 400, a little over 400. Just depends on what day it is because, you know, it just depends. We're a really active group, and there are weekly, daily themes that we follow that are all about mindset. And that gives you an opportunity to interact with me because we also run our live chats there when we're doing live events. I've got a program that runs on Mondays. I've got a program that runs on Tuesdays. And both of those programs, in both of those programs, we chat in my group. And what's cool about that is even though there may be people who are not actually in either of those programs, they're two different programs, even though they're not in the program, what they do is they get the vicarious learning of the posts made by the people who are in the program. So that's a great way to kind of get to know me and get to know the work that I do, especially around mindset. There are promotional opportunities, but they're limited within that group to one day a week, and it's, you know, strictly social media posts that I give people an opportunity to share. That's one way. The other way is I've got a download of a marketing blueprint. It's a workbook where you actually get to identify your ideal client and walk through really fleshing out your knowing of who that is. I've heard people call it an avatar. You know, it's not really an avatar in my mind. It's a profile. It's really helping you get to know your ideal client. Then you can know also how to market to your ideal client. And then you can move your way into the selling strategy and conversation so that you're inviting your ideal client to do business with you. So if they go to my website, they can download that at businessbeyondlimits.com. That's businessbeyondlimits.com. And those are two great ways for people to get to know me and what I do and how I serve.
Businessbeyondlimits.com. I really encourage everybody to go out, check that out. I mean, join the group. It's a private group, but it's a free group, right?
Mm-hmm. It's a free group.
Yeah, and so is the download.
So both of those are no-cost opportunities to get to know me and what I do and how I can help you.
So businessbeyondlimits.com, absolutely. Everybody should go check that out. Well, Wendyy, we like to be good teachers and leave people with something positive that they can take action on right now today. So what are the number one or top couple of things that a person could do right now to really begin putting into practice what we've been talking about here today?
Well, it sounds simple, and it is. But it is really powerful, and that is to, first of all, recognize that mindset is everything. That's my favorite hashtag, mindset is everything. And when you recognize that mindset is everything, you know if you're really trying to grow your business or lose weight or improve your parenting relationship with your kids, whatever it is you're trying to do, create affirmations that support you in your belief, your highest belief about whatever it is you're trying to do. And let me give a quick example. Let me say this, and then I'll give a quick example. After you use the words I am, everything that follows is something that is heard and put into play by your subconscious, by your unconscious mind. So I am, and then what follows is something that your unconscious mind believes for your whole being. That's why affirmations are so valuable, because of what they do to your belief and ultimately your behavior and your actions. My favorite I am statement is, I am in the process of creating money with grace and ease. I'm in the process of creating money with grace and ease. So write affirmations that serve you and support your highest belief in what's possible, because mindset is everything.
And that is really important. Mindset is everything. You know, the old poster, your attitude will determine your altitude, really is true.
Mm-hmm.
As a person thinks, so are they. And that, you know, it is a Bible verse, and it's not talking about, you know, anything that has to do with critiquing another person. It has to do with our internal game. You know, what are the things that you're saying to yourself that are then going to come out in the things that you do? You know, if you say, I'm a horrible person, I'm a failure, all of those kind of things, your mind believes it. It's like, well, okay, you know. You know, Noah St. John's does the whole thing that he talked to us about your mind looks for that reason why that's true. Whereas if you tell yourself, I am rich, I am profitable. I am a powerful, talented, you know, whatever you do. Your mind believes it. It's like, oh, okay, well, I guess I am. All right, cool.
Well, and what happens is because it's in your psyche, it's part of who you are, your behaviors will really reflect whatever that belief is. So you'll make better choices about programs, about clients, about where you play, about what you do. And I'm back to the business person, the coach now that I'm talking to. What will happen is your relationships will reflect your highest belief. Your interactions with people will reflect that. You know, it's sort of like when you know that you are all that and a bag of chips in business, and you know and you believe that and you've told yourself that through your affirmations, the way you show up reflects that belief. And I've seen it happen with myself. I've seen it happen with my clients that they've been somewhere that they really did not think was a business-oriented kind of place and ultimately got clients, contracts, and all kinds of stuff because they were just showing up in that highest belief. Mm. Makes a difference. Totally makes a difference.
Show up as a strong and powerful person that you are. Well, Wendyy, I wish we could go for about another hour or two just talking about this. This is some great stuff. But I really appreciate you taking the time to pour just a little piece of who you are into all of us today.
Not a problem. Thank you so much for the opportunity, Steve, and I hope people got something of value from it.
It really is your mindset that is the very first thing. It's really interesting because, you know, in the life that I live and with doing the interviews and stuff, I get a chance to talk with a lot of really awesome coaches. And every single one of them starts out one way or another with whatever verbiage they put on it, making sure that your mind is right. Think about it back to sports in school. Okay, before you start the game, you know, the coach sits down with you and you have a, here's our plan. But more than that, there's some type of rah-rah, pep-pep kind of thing that you do that gets the juices flowing, gets your mind in the right place. You know, nobody goes into a football game right before they start the opening kickoff and it's like, well, you know, we're probably not going to do it. But go out there and give it a really good shot. And, you know, I mean, even just to be that way in their tone inflection would give a person pause as to whether or not they could do well. Instead, they come in and they're like, okay, gang, we're going to do it. We've got what it takes. You can do it. I believe in you. And then it goes from there. We have to do that in our own lives, in our life, and in our business. We really have to really take the bull by the horns and start off by getting our mind right. So I hope you guys will really all embrace that. I want to give out a special shout out to my wonderful wife, Kathy Kidd. Many of you know her, and she, of course, is the primary sponsor of Thriving Entrepreneur, all the things that her and I do together to help people become bestsellers in the industry. We do that so that you can thrive in your life and business. So thank you so much, as always, to my wonderful wife, Kathy. And to you, the listener, thank you for listening. And remember, you are uniquely brilliant. You were created for a purpose. The world needs you. Kathy and I are here every day to help you live every day of your life as a thriving entrepreneur. Until next time, have a great day and have a great week.
Thanks for listening to Thriving Entrepreneur today. If you want to get your question answered, send an email to questions@wehelpyouthrive.com. We look forward to you joining us again next time.
You've heard Kathy and I talk about it. You've seen the workshops. You have watched as others of your friends have become a best-selling author. And now it's your turn. Let me ask you this. What would being a best-selling author do for your business? Over 80% of people surveyed said that they want to write a book, which means that if you're listening, you probably are one of those people. Now is your time because you have a message that needs to be shared. That message is not for you. It's not for your ego. It is because it serves other people. Kathy and I are here to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. All you need to do is go to wehelpyouthrive.com, check us out, and find out how you can be a best-selling author today.